Some of the languages have got a built-in capability to help the user perform input, output, managing the memory, manipulating data as a part of the language itself. C language takes a slightly different approach. Instead of making things like printf, scanf as a part of the C language, it decides to use a library's help. So using the library, it gets its work done. So C does not have anything on its own to be able to help you to read and write. It takes the help of a library, and using the library functions, it gets things done for you. So things like memory management, reading, writing are all done with the help of a library functions. So the first thing you need to understand is, originally C did not have its library. It used the library that was part of the Unix operating system. C and Unix share a very close relationship. In fact, the first kernel of Unix was written using a high-level language was written in C. So originally the C library was simply considered to be a part of the Unix operating system. Now, what does the library provide for you? Suppose you need to read, you have printf. To read, you have scanf. To print, you have printf. To manipulate the memory, you have various memory management functions. To compare strings, you have string compare and so on. So users are provided through the library functions, ability to do input-output operations, memory manipulation, memory management, okay, and other tasks required for programming. Initially, these functions were created by different user groups and shared among themselves so that the work could be easily done and you didn't have to reinvent the code every time. Now, when the ANSI committee was formed, the popular functions that were developed were incorporated as a part of the ANSI or ISO C. Now you may have noticed when we used printf and scanf, those programs contained at the very top a declaration called as include stdio.h. So what happened is that stdio.h is nothing but it's a header file. The actual code of scanf and printf resides in a library file having an extension .a or .lib, and the linker finds the code of printf and scanf and joins it with your program during linking. So the header file merely contains the model declaration or the prototype declaration of printf and scanf. What does that model and declaration does is, it tells the compiler, I am using a function called as printf and scanf. You don't bother about trying to find where the code is. I am going to give the code later on through the linker. You just compile what code I have written. That's what the header file declaration does. Now, this arrangement of a library is a great facility because you can get a lot of the standard functions or standard code as a part of the library. So you can write your own program. Just indicate in the header file that you are going to use the library. Compile your code and during linking, link them and go ahead and use them. Now all the functions like printf, scanf so far we have used and a number of other functions we are going to use are all a part of the standard ISO C or ANSI C. Compared to other languages, C has a very small set of library as well as library functions. Now you may wonder, why do we develop library functions and why not create our own functions? There are a number of advantages of library functions. The advantage of library functions are, they are developed by experts, thoroughly tested, the code is optimal, and almost always it is error free. It saves you a lot of time instead of you reinventing the code or reinventing the wheel, as they say. Biggest advantage is, the printf which works in my machine is going to behave the same across all the platforms you're going to use it. So consistency of behavior, saving of time, error-free, optimal code, these are the major advantages of system-provided or C-provided functions. As of now, there are 29 header files in C11. Although if you go and see the include directory in your compiler installation, there will be more than 29 because there are some non-standard header files which are provided by the individual compiler. Now, just to refresh and clarify, the header file merely contains declaration of functions, declaration of global variables, constants, and the data types of different variables that may be used during linking. So please do not think that there is any code present in the header file. It is just the declarations are present in the header file.